Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. It's now time to talk about conveyors. Conveyors are a very important part of many robotic stations, but they can be a bit hard to simulate with RoboDK if you don't have the right method. This is exactly what we'll learn in this video. Let's get started. In the first few videos of this module, we've used two conveyors to bring in bottle to our robot scanner. We've used those two conveyors, but we didn't know exactly what we were doing. We were simply calling the right subroutine at the right time. Now it's time to figure out how to build a conveyor and how to properly program it. Okay, so to do that, let's press escape a few times to stop that simulation, and I will press Ctrl N to create a new station. First thing we'll do is go to our online library. So I'll click here on the blue globe and we will go get one of the conveyor we have in our library to get started. So let's go under type. If I'm not mistaken, it's under object and you have conveyor belt. You have two type of conveyor. You have either model mechanism or you have model Python simulation. I honestly believe that we should completely remove the model Python simulation one as it's not efficient. It's really laggy and it's so much easier to use the mechanism one. So I would recommend you to kind of forget about this one as much as possible. So let's click on download to download our conveyor belt to meter here. I'm going to simply drag and drop it to RoboDK just like that. The first thing you will notice is the conveyor comes with a conveyor belt base, which is a reference frame, the same way a robot would do. And you have conveyor belt here, which is the actual conveyor. If you double click the conveyor, you will see a panel appearing that looks pretty much like the robot panel. That's normal. A conveyor in RoboDK is just a mechanism, and all the mechanisms in RoboDK, including the robot, have the same kind of robot panel. So from here, you could add a tool to the conveyor, you could have a reference frame, and so on and so forth. That's generally not very useful for a conveyor, but what is useful is the joint axis jog. As you can see for now, it goes from -500,000 millimeters to 500,000 millimeters. So that's quite a bit, so like 500 meter in one direction, 500 meter in the other direction. If I press the plus arrow here, moving upward, you will see a little reference frame moving along the conveyor. So this is the way we simulate the conveyor belt moving along the conveyor. So we have a reference frame, and this reference frame is moving along the conveyor like if it was a linear rail. If I go back to my pick and scan program, remember under world I had one bottle hidden here as a reference. I'm going to Control C this bottle, go back to my new station, and then here under conveyor belt I will right click and I will add a reference frame, add it directly to the conveyor belt here. So right click here, I will double click it, click on it, and I will remove any value so that it's at zero. We'll call it here conveyor object, and I will Control V the bottle I had, and I will make it visible by right-clicking visible. Now, if you look, when I press the arrows in either direction on the conveyor, the object is moving with it. If I wanted to have the object a bit more in the middle, I could either move the object by double clicking the object and changing the position here, or I can decide to double click on the reference frame and move the reference frame towards the center of the conveyor, just like that, let's say. So that would also work. And oops, here I click home, and just like that, I can move in either directions my object. So that's the first thing. So that's the general concept of how the conveyor works. So it's a linear rail or a linear axis, in fact, that can move in either direction up to a certain value of the limit of the joints. So if you were to create one yourself, you could go under utilities and then model mechanisms and robot, and you can simply create a linear rail, and a linear rail or conveyor in this case are exactly the same. I will have a video on that specific subject in a few modules. I think it's module 6, basic mechanisms, where I will show you how to build one from scratch. But for now, we'll be using this one here we have. Okay, the next thing we need to do is show how we can create the most basic program with the conveyors. So if you remember from the simulation we did, the way our conveyor was working is by increment. So we were moving the bottles one by one, a certain, or the conveyor one shot at a time by a certain distance so that a new bottle would come in. So if I open the conveyor program here, next part in, it's moving just a bit. So now it's in fast forward. So it's moving just one blow. So that's a bit harder, and we will cover that in the next video. For this video here today, we will simply create a conveyor that moves continuously at a continuous speed and on which we can drop objects so that it can simply follow a certain speed along the conveyor. So let's bring the conveyor back to its own position. And I will create here under conveyor belt base a first target that I will call conveyor home, and I will change that for a join target. That will be my home position here. If I move, let's say, the conveyor in the right direction, so let's go for 2000 here, and I can create here a new target and call it conveyor run, let's say, and make it a join target. Now, if I double click on conveyor home, the robot will come back to its home position, or the conveyor will come back to its home position. Then I can create a program here, call it run conveyor, like that. And I can call the run conveyor target here as a move J, like that here. And you can see the yellow line appearing. So if you want the yellow line appearing to disappear, you just have to right click and display path. Here, there's one thing I want to kind of bring your attention to before we go any further. If you right click the conveyor program and you go under robot, you will see that now it's linked with conveyor belt. So this is something very important we'll have to account for in a few minutes, is we need to link the right mechanism or robot to the right program. So a program that would be dedicated like this one, or yeah, dedicated to moving the conveyor forward, shouldn't be linked with the robot. If you have more than one option here, it should be linked with the conveyor belt, obviously. So that's fine as is. If I double click here and run that here, you'll see that the conveyor is moving the object towards the final position. So that's one way of moving the conveyor forward. If you wanted to have something that simply moves continuously, what you can do is, here, instead of having the move conveyor or the run conveyor position at the end of the conveyor, here you can have it like way further. So let's say we put it at 500,000 millimeters, right click, teach current position, and then double click the home here. So we bring the robot back to its own position, and then we click the run conveyor. It will simply move towards the end of the station, which in this case doesn't really exist. So it will move up until it reached the 500,000 millimeters, which can take a bit of time. If we bring that back to home, if you're not satisfied with the speed at which the robot runs, first of all, make sure that your simulation speed makes sense, or simulation ratio makes sense. So in this case, we'll go for about 2 for 2. You can select parameters here, and under joint speed and joint acceleration, you can change here the speed. So we can say, okay, 5,000 degrees or millimeters per second in this case is a bit much. So we'll go for 1,000, and here for acceleration, we'll also go for 1,000. So we kind of pick up a bit faster here, and we'll click okay. If I bring home here, run conveyor, whew, now it's running a bit faster. You might say, but why is it running faster? I kind of reduced the speed by 5. Yeah, yes, but we increased the acceleration quite a bit. So before it was 50 degrees per second or 50 millimeters per second, meaning that before reaching the 5,000 degrees per second, it could take like about 100 seconds, which is quite long. Now we reach the meter per second in less than a second. So that might be a bit fast here. So maybe 500 would makes more sense. And then I can bring back this to its home position, run here. And now we have the object moving outward. One important thing here, if you look, I made sure to have the bottle part of the conveyor object reference frame here, which is part of the conveyor belt. So that's important because this is the way we'll be able to drop objects on the conveyor and have them fly with the mechanism we just created. So if we try to apply the same method to our pick and scan here, remember what we had so far, and we'll have to kind of undo a bit of what we already have. What we have so far is when we go, main program here, we init everything. We come here, we pick the bottle, then we have an increment of one position here for the out or the in conveyor. Then we place it here and we have one increment and then that's it. But let's say that we want to just have this conveyor here moving and just continuing its bringing the bottle to the next station without waiting for the other one to come in. So what we could do is, instead of having here in our pick and scan, instead of using the next part out, what we will do is create a run program that we will launch at the init and simply leave it to be and leave it to run, in fact, during the whole process. So it will simply pick the objects and move them. So let's create a new program here. Let's call it run conv out, run conveyor. Let's add a underscore here. So let's run conveyor out. Under conveyor out base, I'm going to double click the conveyor here and I will move it very quickly. I'm going to bring it home, make sure that I'm moving in the right direction. I'm going to move it at 500,000 millimeters and I will create a target here. So this target here, right click, needs to be linked with the right conveyor or the right mechanism. So in this case, it's going to be linked with conveyor out. I will right click, make it a join target, right click, teach current position to make sure that I'm recording the 5,000 millimeters here. And I will name it run conveyor, just like that. Perfect. So now what I can do is call here and make sure that I have the right. Okay, so near here, the run conveyor out subroutine that I created needs to be linked to the conveyor out too. So we need to select the right mechanism in our station and we can create our move J in this case here and remove this set frame here. And if we bring our robot or mechanism back to its home position and select the run conveyor out, you will see it bring in the bottle out. So now we can modify the speed potentially. So again, here, this is a bit fast, 500, let's say, even 250 would make sense here. 250, 250, 250. I'm going to put 250 everywhere and I will hide the pad here. Oops, I'm going to reframe. Okay, if you're stuck like that and you don't know where your station is, you can just right click the robot, let's say, and you select frame on, it will bring back your station to the right spot. Okay, perfect. I will bring back this to its home position. And if here in the main program, or in fact in the pick and scan, I will remove the run next part out because I will add in the init a program call just after the go home, right click, add instruction, program call instruction. I will select my run conveyor out and I will make it a start thread. So this way, run conveyor out will simply run as long as it needs towards the end of the station or outside of the screen while the rest of the program is still running. So if I do that and I run my main program, let's hope everything works according to plan. We wait a few seconds and then we place the bottle on the out conveyor, and the bottle is moving out towards the next station that needs to process it in a given way. So here, obviously, it looks a bit weird because the conveyor has an end and the bottles are still moving. But here you can see we can simply have a conveyor kind of endlessly moving stuff in this direction. Make sure before you rerun the program to bring it back to its home position, because at some point it will reach the end and then the move J won't work anymore. So you need to bring it back to its home position before you relaunch it so that you have a bit more room to move objects along the conveyor. Okay, so that's pretty much everything for the first part of the conveyor training or tutorials. In the next video, we will see how to create incremental motions and how to reinitialize the position of the conveyor automatically before launching it, so that you don't have to double click and select move home manually. You can just launch the init and the program or the robot's position will be initialized automatically. The same way we already did here with the initial init conveyor position. We'll see what's in there. Hope it helps, and in any case, have a great day, guys.